Okay, we're ready to rock and roll. Pokemon, call and see them. What's poppin', gang? Echo, Nathan. We're gonna be big chillin' today. Yeah, stop stibbing, bro. I'm glad you've tuned in, though. Yeah, I've already started the game at this point. Not too far into it. Look at my team. Look at the second gen team. Featuring Makuhita. Oh, that was a cutscene. He was like really. At least he just rolled up. Yeah, this game rocks, man. It's also notoriously hard. But I had this game as a kid, way back in the day. What's funny is this game was made by a bunch of the, like, Dragon Quest people. So that's why it has, like, a different tone to it. So the windmill stopped working. I would say I get the power. I love this music too. It's one of my favorite soundtracks. I didn't lose the damn gear. I can use a key. Me and my whip. Here's the gear. my save, actually. Can I save? Yeah. Better get her ass beat. Oh shit, I forgot what that.
Grand Finals.
Oh, this theme rocks. Totally forgot. Damn, that had a grip. Oh, he knows bite? That's not good. Ooh, one knockout punch. Thank you. Won the tournament? I believe so, yeah. Sounds like an ambush to me. Yo, muscular alligator, what is poppin'? How you doing, my man? I love Colosseum. It's probably in my top three, like, favorite Pokemon games, like, ever. And definitely one of my favorite GameCube ones. Ooh. It's the Yanma. I don't want to kill it. What is he actually grass type? There was rock. Plus, that's Fortress, where he turns into steel type, I believe, or rock or something like that. It's been a long time. It did like no damage. Of course he digs.
Let's get it.
Ah, it's so hard in this game, man. The catch rate's so hard in this game.
We can try it, but it might be too much.
Just enough, okay.
I gotta get him now, dude.
Got his ass. Woo! I love the Shadow Pokemon mechanic in this game, because it makes it, like, I could have just cruised through those guys, but, like, I want him so bad, I have to catch him, you know, because once you kill him, it's over. You know, there are no wild encounters in this game, so you have to, like, make it count. Yo, Totodile's my OG, man. Picked him back in, what was it, 99 when the game came out? Named him Alligator, and it was spelt really badly, because I was, like, six or five. I mean, yeah.
What is this suspicious thing right here?
Hypermode. Shadow Pokemon, perhaps because of their own overwhelming power, may behave abnormally at times. They may engage in such behavior as ignoring orders or even turning on their own trainers in battle. This I have named Hypermode. The plus side, Hypermode raises the critical ratio of Shadow Rush. However, Hypermode also prevents the use of items on the Pokemon. Actually, Hypermode is easily dispelled. Simply call the Pokemons by name. However, this method has a major drawback. Calling the Shadow Pokemon's name causes the closed door part to loosen, even open. That's actually a good thing. Unticks what I'm doing. Yo, bro, leave me alone, dude. Okay, can I just go in the elevator? Ooh, Larvitar. Please be Shadow.
Please be Shadow. Come on.
Eyes nut. Damn, Clay wasn't Shadow. He would've been dead as hell, man.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
How's everyone doing today, huh? Everybody big chillin'? Hell yeah, man. Hell yeah.
What? Yo, that's crazy.
What are your plans, man? What do you want to do? Street Fighter? You should do some Street Fighter. Especially with Ed coming out, which I will be streaming that. I'll be doing a Road to Masters with Ed when he comes out. Yeah, Epic has some issues, right? Thank you. You saw Snake Eyes is in the Capcom Cup with Geef, trying to get that $1 million with Geef, which that sure is a choice. Wish him the best of luck on that, honestly. Oh, great.
I've got to go back and heal.
Open the door. Gotta fight this nerd.
And Woopa! Let me some Woopa.
You excited for that Sonic Generations, Sonic X Shadow Generations? Yeah, Zangief, man, he's one of my worst matchups, personally. Yeah, but you know, I'm like, there's like a dedicated, like story for them. Like, they're doing like a Shadow the Hedgehog, like, levels and shit. I think it's pretty cool.
I didn't know I had that ability.
Thank you. They're both in hyper mode? This is not good. Great ball, five of them? Yeah, I'll take five great balls, hell yeah. Get Crocodile out of there ASAP, fucking P, dude. Ever going to attack? Boosting your attack all day and you're not attacking. Oh, because the ghost move and it's normal flying. Roger that. This is quite the gauntlet, don't lie. Sfeel and Snorunt. Third generous right here. Well, okay, so actually I have some thoughts on that. I'm glad you asked. Let's see here, one second. So, it's really funny because Pokemon is the highest grossing, like, franchise of all time. Still is. I don't think anything will ever actually top it. The problem is that, like, I don't know if Game Freak is lazy or if they're trying to push out too many games at once and losing the quality control. Because here's the thing. I watched my partner play through Pokemon Scarlet and Violet. It's got some really cool quality. It's actually a good, believe it or not, it's actually a pretty good game. There's actually not a whole lot wrong with it, besides the graphical fidelity, and like it doesn't look amazing. Even compared to like Sword and Shield, it doesn't look, you know, very amazing. But there are some cool things about it, you know? That's the thing. I really just want Game Freak, and it really is just Pokemon Company at this point, to like really take their time with these games, because, you know, ever since it moved to home platforms, you know, it's no longer like a pocket experience anymore. I don't think they were quite ready for that jump. You know. However, it doesn't really excuse it, because the people who made those games back in the day was a much smaller team, you know. Like, Palworld is like, it's just this big, like, oh, they made a Pokemon game, well, they're gonna react to it, and it got a lot of publicity, and it sold a lot. But, like, is it fun? I've never played it, you know, I don't really have an interest to play it. But I'm also not defending Pokemon on that regard, because, like, it's just some, like, it's a hack of a game. You know, it's just stealing everything this game has done down to, like, you know, I said assets back in the day, and while it may not be assets, they did definitely... Their character designs range from heavily inspired to straight up stolen in concept. You know, give or take. I don't care that they're stealing from the, you know, billion-dollar corporation. I'm more upset that it's like, it could be its own thing. You know, it's just there to be like, oh, look, it's crazy they're stealing from Pokemon, but it's actually not, you know, it could have been its own thing and used the same formula. And been good, you know, because there's plenty of games out there that replicate this play, you know, this genre that is its own thing. It's not really my shtick, but I'll take your word for it. Like, here's the crazy concept, right? I like Pokemon because it has Pokemon in it. It's some of the greatest character designs of all time. You know, I like the world. I like the soundtrack. You know, it's not just the game itself, like, whatever, you know, but I'm just here to play with toys, you know. I'm here to play with the creatures. Especially older ones like this, I really like a lot.
Oh shit.
Didn't think about that. All the way back down to Helix.
All right. Rock and roll.
Second game.
All right, we are back.
Let's see. Let's see.
Oh, I didn't think it'd kill him.
It happens, I suppose. Remoraid's not that cool anyway. A Manton on the other hand. That is something I gotta get.
Hey, yo, Charlie! I got the Coliseum, Charlie!
You need to go outside, probably, Echo. Get some fresh air. Get away from it all for a little bit. Actually, Charlie, what's your first favorite title? Good, good, good. Yeah, definitely go outside if it's getting too much on the inside. Yeah, you used to be able to do it by, like, the old DS had the Game Boy Advance cartridge in it. Did you have to, like, go to the Safari Zone and catch them or some shit? This game actually had some exclusives, I believe. Yeah, Emerald and Gold. Yeah. Third and second gen are super, super good. Sometimes it'd be lucky enough to get, like, you know, one copy of a Pokemon, like, for my birthday, and then, like, get another copy from, like, Christmas from somebody else or something, so I'd, like, trade the in-between.
I was super lucky back in the day.
This thing does not get confused. I'm seconds to get Noctowl out. Yeah, the fucking the Game Boy player was sick. What? I used to play like Sonic Advance and like and Pokemon games on it all the time. Still have mine actually. I have the e-reader too. God, that did a lot. No, you don't have it anymore? What a lamer, dude. Yeah, this game is super sick. I have it physically. As well as Gale of Darkness. I have that as well still. Though I prefer this one. Even with Shadow Lugia, it's like the coolest thing ever. Man, here's my strat. Boys up. Ooh, that hurts. Yo, I got the big Bulbasaur, hell yeah. And then we're gonna go for it. Let's see. Come on, baby, let it rip! Yeah, I did the same thing. I got my Lugia purified, moved over to Sapphire. Got that sucker to level 100 and gave it like a lot of I forgot what the defense protein was, but like its defense was as high as it could go. It was like unbeatable. My man.
this thing here. Check it out.
A shadow Pokemon is a Pokemon that has been made into a fighting machine by artificially shutting the door to its heart. We didn't know that shadow Pokemon exude a dark aura that can't normally even be seen by the human eye. Fortunately, a girl with the ability to see this dark aura has been discovered. This is a major problem. The girl could become a huge obstacle for our shadow Pokemon plan. A solution to this threat is urgently needed. That's my shawty right here. That's my shawty right here. The Pokemon, yes, they're evil. Yeah, she's awesome. She's probably my favorite. One of my favorite characters, like, ever. She's kind of bug-eyed, but I like her because she's bug-eyed. Or B. We're good on here. Oh yeah, I have to get that town. That's like one of my favorite places in like Pokemon is that little town. That was the only way to get Celebi in third gen, wasn't it? Like, for a long time, it was only through this game. The coolest thing they did with the 3DS ports of, like, the original, like, Game Boy games is that in the Crystal version, they actually made the Celebi event, like, a thing. You can actually get it in that game, legitimately, by going to the shrine and all that jazz. I guess I can't. Oh, you got an annual leaf lock? The patented leaf lock? I've never tried a Nuzlocke, actually. I was thinking about it recently. What I usually do on my my phone whenever I'm out and about, I've got the games emulated on my phone, like, I think it's Emerald and Blue. And in Blue, I have a level 35 Blastoise, and I just beat, like, Surge. Because Because I make the challenge where it's like, only use the starter. And I'm like, can you just beat Pokemon with the starter? Like, just run that shit? I'm like, it seems so. It seems like at this point you absolutely can. Actually, it wouldn't work. I'm normal. Yeah, it's crazy, man.
Ah, don't poison me. Oh, that sucks, dude. I hate being poisoned in these games.
Oh god, that fucking hurt. And hyper mode, this is great, this is wonderful. Shabby, not too shabby, okay. And we'll give it an American try. Let's go for it. Oh yeah, just grass types? That's rough. That's actually really rough. Ooh, I hope this doesn't kill it. Perfect. Actually perfect.
Let it rip.
Come on, man. Yeah, Hisui and Quillfish is actually really cool.
That's like a rip.
Oh man, it's gotta stop doing that, man. It's got to. I could use a great ball and definitely catch it, but. Puts his back into it, man. Sick. Okay, I'm gonna try one more Pokeball. And if this doesn't work, I'll use a Great Ball. Feeling. Okay, it's great ball time. Jesus, man. No way, dude. You have got to be kidding me. It is so hard to catch these guys, man. It's nuts. It's nuts. Yeah, I'm about to put his ass to sleep here. Ooh, I gotta get him now, dude, or it's over. Ah, okay, it all comes down to this. I don't even want him that bad. Use a Shadow Rush, it's over. Okay, it's not quite over yet. Jesus! Ah, but his evasiveness is like way higher though. Man, this guy's being a butt. I'm just gonna use a Pokeball. I'm about to just kill it. I don't want it that bad. Admit, dude. I'm wasting all my shit. Ah, man. At this point, I'm like running out of options. Just for this one guy. Finally it works. Okay. Okay, one more time. One more time. Finally, dude. It wasn't fun for me. It was a chore.
I gotta walk all the way into town. Oh, of course, the poison.
Probably the lamest thing they ever did. Let's be honest. Hey, who else is poisoned, dude? I could use the elevator. I didn't think about it. It's better than the abrasive ass, like, poison effect from the old games. Oh, we gotta go all the way into town. Get my whip. Soul here. Ugh. Come on, dude. Okay. Is there anything? Yeah, I'm not really big in the stat. I save. I cannot recall if I saved. I probably did.
Pathway.
Ooh, nice and easy. Need you to tell me.
Hyper potion, I'll take those, thank you.
Don't you do this to me. Come on, man. Don't you do this to me. That's so lame, dude. Yeah, really, though. The scaling in this game is really funky. Come on, man. What are you waiting for? Gotta get the boys back in the picture. Oh yeah, that's... Poison is so annoying, man. I hate it. It's like, bro. This was the exact same team used in the Coliseum fight. Champion had them, or the runner-up to champion, my final fight. Oh, who's the shadow Pokemon? Ah, oh, shit. Okay. Bro, he could have used it on the other guy. Would have been way better. He's getting BTFO'd. Okay, so I'm going to switch to Noctowl. It seems like status effects really help the catcher in this game, so I'm gonna do that. This guy's gonna end up killing himself, dude. I should have just thrown the ball just to see the chance, honestly. But... Oh no. Oh, dude, no. No, I wanted the Medicham. Come on. That was such a successful confuse rate. That's insane. We move on. Wait, you didn't see me before?
kiss my ass, Cody, you bitch! Also, welcome, my man. What's up, Robin? What's going on? What's going on, bro?
Interesting. Get the job first, bro. Get the job first. It's good to hear, though. Oh yeah, it's super, super fun. Let me know, we'll jam some when you get it. Hold on, I gotta refill here. Power up. We gotta get Dunsparce, he's tight. So, we kind of learned our lesson from earlier. I think I'll just bite her.
Damn, that shit hurts.
Use reflect. It's bullying my Espeon.
What the fuck?
You big bully. Of course, I forgot. Gacnia? Oh, shit. Even with defense, that would hurt so much, man, without reflect. Holy shit. Bite him. Get knocked out here.
Good evening, Ultraviolet. Welcome to the stream.
What's poppin', bro? Glad to hear it, man. You get that big dinner? Big dinner?
Oh, don't even need it. Don't even need it. We got the Dunsparce.
McDonald, hell yeah. McDonald, the Mickey D on the Valentine's Day. Ah, yeah, we're here. We're finally here. Man, did I save? I really gotta like pay real close attention when I save. Okay. We're moving up in the world. Come on, nerd. Lombre. Yeah, it's getting me ready for Mirror B. What a lamer. Let's wrap this up. Ba-da-da-dum.
Stronger.
There's so many people. Confusion's so good, man. cleaning house right now. It's over. The TKO. I mean, what's down here? Got me curious now. Oh wait. Oh, that's what's her name? She's a baddie, but she's got to go. Didn't kill really the defense on this thing. I became confused. Ah, oh, you so bad, dude. Got some tough cookies here. Please don't use poison sting, please. Ooh, you love to see it. You love to see it. Oh, and that's not what I want to do. Ah, oh, God. So whatever's next is weak to psychic. Not bad against it. Or it gets a bite. Never mind. There's confusion too. I'm getting everything mixed up here. Hey, everything worked out in the end. Look at that. Dunzo. There's what's her name? Inching a go-go, baby. The peon! So good, man. It's so good. This music? Listen to this music, dude! This music was composed by one of the Dragon Quest alumni. That's why it's so good, and also, my bad. I think the microphone's too close to my mouth. There's a time and place for it, man. MIDI, guitar MIDI sounds really good, depending on the context. Oh, that's not good. Oh, never mind. He's doing the wrong one. Okay, so Dustox is poison, so I should use confusion. Fucks.
Gust of wind.
The solo rock for a minute.
Easy peasy, lemon squeezy.
Okay, don't try to psych me out. Oh, I did go the wrong way. All these baddies down here in the sewer, man. Oh, you're not even, like, part of it. I love that design so much. Got Zig and Zagoon. You gotta love it, man. You gotta love it. Pokemon call and see them. Yeah, it does sound like an AC joke, doesn't it? I think about it. Stuff. Well, an iron, I will definitely take it. Look at all this, man. This is definitely worth the pilgrimage. I was gonna end the stream at 2 hours, but man, we still gotta find Mirror B. Go ahead and use... let's make the stats here. Can I not see their stats? Info, there we go. No. Oh, there it is. Let's see. Attack 56. Special defense is great, but attack. Special attack. Speed. Special attack is fucking great. Special defense is pretty good. Speed's pretty good. Defense is a little lackluster. Oh, I see what you mean. Let's see. Different defense. I think it's good for special defense. This is good for speed, which an Umbreon actually needs. Protein is good for attack, which, guess what? Umbreon needs. It's Espeon that is helping you in. Aw, oh, who do we got? Ah, I kinda want that though. Swablu. Okay, we're playing the long game here, so. Altaria is like a pseudo-legendary. She booted up, man. Wish I can get that Beldum, because Metagross is sick as shit. Not very effective, however, psychic and steel, so I thought. Or. I wonder if the steel negates that. We do confusion to Swablu. That could be it. Let's use return. Yeah, good old return. Can't beat that.
Lumbre!
All right, just one more left? Okay.
Oh, he's helping hand, not he's the wrong one.
I used the exact wrong one. That's not good.
Give him some NyQuil.
Here's what we'll do. You ready? And then it's probably in a good place, so I'll just call out to him. Oh, and it's just that easy. God, these fights are long, man. Definitely a new place. Oh, that looks new, doesn't it? If that's the case, let's explore a bit. Oh yeah, no, that was a good call. That was actually a really good call. Oh man, how far we've come. I need to do a... As it's gonna get, man. It's as good as it gets. Definitely one of the best themes in the game, baby.
Hunter!
Osama de Amigos type shit. Okay, play the long game. Redundant, isn't it?
Ooh, don't do that. Don't do it. Don't do it on SPI. Don't do it. Ah.
One down, five to go. Thankfully, they're not doing too much damage. Oh, you love the crit. You love the crit. Come on, man. Come on, dude. Jesus. All these freaking Ludicolos, dude. Alright, gotta reflect again. Confuse Ray. I can reflect the game. Time to go full ham on this.
I know, it's so stupid, man. Huge, massive crit.
I think the Pseudo Will is actually Shadow.
Yep.
There's another one. I think the third. Okay. Yeah, Pseudo Will is tight, man. Okay. Let's get this Ludicolo out of the way. Espeon's been getting it, man.
Espeon.
Oh, that hurts. I fucking forgot.
Kind of in a little bit of a tough spot here. Give me a crit, come on. Ah, not quite. Oh, it's confused though, that's good. Okay, cool. Come on, one more.
Oh, yeah, baby!
Leech Seed, man. The fucking Leech Seed. Does it ever grow away? The Umbreon can... Yeah, man. Little man is fucking running, dude. Hell, he'll get a... He's level 35. Let's just fucking go on him. Ooh, that fucking hurts. Okay.
God damn it.
God. It's a crit. It's over. So I'm just gonna use Reflect.
Missed. That's horrible. Is that good? Here it comes. Critical it and super effective.
Okay, we're gonna have to get creative with this one. I can beat it, but like getting him is gonna be a little difficult. At least he's bugging me, dude. Fuse Ray. Return.
Oh,
No, come on, bro.
Oh, one HP. You're a trooper.
Oh, not the Leech Seed. I forgot.
Lilith Gamer. It's popping, Lil. How you doing?
Gotta go for it.
Swing that shit. Come on.
Ah, that's gonna be sick. One more time. Yeah, I'm big chillin' a little. Just streaming some Pokemon Call and See Them.
No, you fucker!
Oh, it's happening, don't worry. The Road to Master with Ed and the character guide. All gonna be coming out. This is gonna fucking hurt. Okay, let's see. Oh, wait. They dropped it today? Oh, shit. Okay, okay. We'll beat this guy and we'll look at it real quick for you in the stream.
No, you fucker, dude. You can't be doing this to me.
You can't be doing this to me.
Oh, crit. You're out of your fucking mind, dude. Oh, the reflect. Oh, I needed that reflect really badly, actually. Okay. This is Pokemon Coliseum. Yeah, it's gonna be sick. I think I'll probably do a, I did it before already, way back, but I think I'll run through, arcade mode with Ed. Right before he drops, maybe. And stream that shit.
No! I'm not believing hard enough.
Actually, what moves does he have? Does he, is there anything I can use here? I mean, maybe. Fuck it.
Come on, give me your energy, chat. Give me the energy. You guys give me the energy, let's go!
Hell yeah. One, two, three, four. I thought it was five Ludicolos or whatever. Jeez Louise, man. Checking around. Okay.
Give me that shit.
Shadow Pokemon are fighting machines created by closing the door of their hearts. The process of restoring a Shadow Pokemon back to its original state is known as purification.
I knew that for Pokemon Go.
Exactly how a Shadow Pokemon is purified is unclear, but there appear to be several causes. We must eliminate reaction. To these factors. And create a Shadow Pokemon that will never revert back to its original purified form. Shadow Pokemon Lab. Macho Breeze, I'll give that to Ikuhate Watawasha. This is what Lil looks like. Right here.
You found him, my little buddy. You beat that fucker and you brought things back to normal.
I forgot what this guy's deal was, the kid's deal. He's like,
I got to stop them.
I mean, I don't really want it. Just that easy, gang. Oh yeah, for the Valentine's Day event, right? You gotta grind that shit. Alright, let me save up here and I'll switch over and watch the Ed Guide real quick. Gang. All right, let me reconvert here. Of course, absolutely. One of my favorite games, like, ever. Looked up Ed Character Guide, it wasn't even the first fucking result. Alright, let's check this out real quick, gang. Oh, it's Japanese voice. Ed, like any traditional boxer, utilizes a quick flurry of punches alongside slower but long-reaching flicker attacks. Punch button performs easy-to-use, close-range attacks, while the kick buttons perform flicker punches that can hit an opponent from a distance. Also, A variety of target combos are available from Ed's flicker punches, giving you easy options to pile up the damage even from a distance. Oh shit. Even if the opponent stays out of your regular flicker attack range, you can use Psycho Flicker, a special move that covers even more ground to control the ground game. You can also use Psycho Knuckle to close the gap in a hurry. Yeah, naturally, head up in five. Psycho Spark. Close range punch that generates a ball of psycho power, good for close range combos or to cancel out an opponent's incoming projectile, which he had also in five. Ed says himself, this here's a wicked downward punch cloaked in psycho power. Even if it's blocked, it'll have a hard time landing a hard counterattack. So when you're throwing out normal attacks that leave you wide open, cancel them with this. Well, that's safe on block, more or less. Spaced out evenly.
You can follow up with a badass move called the Psycho Shoot that sends the psycho power flying forward, change up the speed by using different punch strengths. Ooh, he did not have that in 5.
Because what you would do, forward medium punch, and then you would hit forward medium punch again. And he would send it out, but there's only one speed. So now he actually gets different speeds, which actually makes him a character. Yes, pretty slow one. That's the medium. That's pretty fast. The heavy one is pretty damn fast. Holy shit. The icing on the cake is that Psycho Spark can cancel out any projectiles an opponent sends your way, letting you bust out a Psycho Shoot to retaliate. So you can nullify it and then shoot another one. Which you could do in 5. You could do it in 5, but it wasn't nearly as strong. Overdrive. Both the Psycho Spark and Shoot become 2 hit attacks. Naturally. Oh, you see how slow that is? You could definitely go in behind that with like a rush, for sure. It's also super fast, man. Okay. Hard to counter, easy to use in combo, Psycho Spark is going to be your go-to attack. So that's safe. And a combo extender, that's really fucking good. Unleash a powerful uppercut cloaked in Psycho Power, useful for countering an opponent's jump attacks or a way to close out combos. So, anti-air and the end piece of your sandwich for your combos. Light version unleashes a mean uppercut in place while the medium and heavy ones move forward before they unleash the nasty. This attack's invincible against mid-air attacks, so use it with as a welcome present when someone gets too jumpy with you. Just remember that some versions move you forward, so adjust accordingly. So kind of like Cammy's DPs, because she kind of like moves forward depending. So if you try to like use like a heavy DP on a character and they're kind of jumping over you, it's not going to reach because they're going to go like in front and then behind. And from what I saw from the trailer, oh, he can do that? Hold on. Yeah, don't jump over that. Holy shit. Hit him when they're high enough and you'll get a chance to land another attack before they kiss the dirt. So we saw this earlier in the trailer. How pre-cognizant do you have to be for that? If you get a good anti-air, you just get a combo. That's crazy. I think they're like one of the only characters in the game that can do that with their specials. I'm trying to think of another one that can do it. Overdrive him with a smoking uppercut that's invincible to their attacks, then bring him crashing down. Pretty sick, right? So invincible reversal. And it seems like unlike Ed, or unlike Luke in this case, his DP always knocks down. The caveat to this, however, from what I'm seeing, you see how far it moves them forward? So for Okazeme, you're going to have to spend 2 bars for the uppercut and then use a driver shin, and that might not even be real. you know. But it depends, because Ed plays really good at this range right here with his Psycho Flicker and Snatcher. So maybe it's, you know. Oh, god damn, that Ghost 3 projectile's good. Holy shit.
Damn, how the fuck?
He steps forward a bit and goes, god, that's good. Holy shit. Yeah, real shit. This attack takes some time to come out, so I would try and snipe an opponent's quick attacks with it. But if they screw up and they're wide open after an attack, hit them hard with this. Yeah, Luke's combos, when you know them like in full, are like really crazy. And Ed's gonna be even crazier. Oh, so they even tell you, like, this attack takes some time to come out. Yeah, so in 5, he had the same thing where, like, most reversals in this game, you can't fuzzy them. In other words, you can't, like, mash a button on their wake up and get, like, a jab in because they start, like, super quick, like, frame 3 or, like, 2 or some shit like that, or 4. His, even in 5, had a delay to it, so what you could do is knock him down, throw a few jabs to, like, keep him in place, but then you'd have enough time to block his uppercut. But the thing about that is, for some reason, I don't know exactly the properties, like why it works this way, but it's got a really big, like, active invulnerability window. So you could be going for like a typical like block string or something you think is like relatively safe, and he can just eat right through it. A lot of Eds used to, including myself, used to dash up and like just uppercut because it would beat grabs and everything on it, because it wouldn't actually connect until later, so you couldn't fuzzy block it. So that's, I guess he still has that. Psycho Blitz. Unleash is a combination of a punches cloaked in psycho power, useful when canceling from normal attacks or as a way to close out combos. So this is kind of his 1-2-3. It's not a Psycho Flicker because that's a dedicated new thing, but like it's the same kind of idea. This is a triple, or classic triple flurry. The medium and heavy versions knock down an opponent, giving you a chance to fold him like a bad poker hand. Jesus. So I bet the frame data is going to be the biggest thing about that. Because the biggest buff he got in 5 was that his Psycho Flicker, his 1-2-3, was relatively safe, and the pushback made it very safe, to the point to where he could steal a turn back, and that's what made him really good near the end of a 5's lifespan. So we'll have to see what that turns into. Also, again, think about this as well. I knew he would have this, and it's good to see that it's still here. That's going to eat through Drive Impact. That's absolutely going to eat through Drive Impact, because it's 3 hits. The armor is only 2. It's going to go 1-2-3. And it's going to beat your DI every time. This is best used to egg combos, so make sure it connects. When the attack is blocked, it leaves you open, which is something all good boxers want to avoid. Ah, so it's unsafe and block. Oh, I see the stage like crumbling in the background. So the overdrive version of it, pepper them with series of body blows before sending them into the air with an uppercut. The opponent can't freely counter attack even if they block it, so it's hella good. So it's safe on block. I almost forgot to add the best part. You're going to be dealing some saucy damage with, if this hits. So if you see any opening, go all in. So it's going to be doing a lot, okay? Yeah, Cammy's gonna have a hard time. He looks fucking good. Now, I will have to get my hands on him to see how good he actually is. But, you know, he's looking pretty good. He's got everything he needs. I just have to look at the frame data. Well, so far it's looking good. A quick flicker jab cloaked in psycho power. Hold down the button to boost its attack properties or cancel into kill rush. Okay. So Flicker goes into Snatcher if you hold it. The button you press for the determines the attack trajectory. Light shoots straight out, medium nips the feet and has good range. Heavy shoots up diagonally and only hits airborne opponents. So that's also good for an anti-air. He's got multiple anti-airs, which is something that both the DLC characters don't really have. Hold the attack button down to go in charge stance, then let go to attack. If you hold down the button long enough, you can also boost the properties of the attack. That's where Snatcher comes into play. Here's the thing. Does it grab on block, though? The boosted version of the attack will pull opponents to you, giving you a chance to smash their face in. If they block it, you can get a move first. What? You got the chance to go on the offensive. Okay, no, that was also true. Where if you use Psycho Snatcher in 5, like the fully charged one, and they blocked it, you actually got to turn back. So you got to watch out for Ed's charging this one. While you're charging up, you can also opt for a Kill Rush instead. Keep mixing it up to really get in their head. So Poison also had this in Street Fighter V, where she had her charged whip special, and you actually couldn't tell which one it was until she released it. And what she could do is she'd cancel that stance before the attack comes out and then just do something else. So it's a very similar-ish game. Yeah, you can go in. Ah, yeah, see? Yep. Shoots out straight like the light version, but features longer range. And it also acts as like the charged version. This version of Flicker will put opponents immediately, and yep, hit them with it, and you can follow up with another attack. Oh, and you're at an advantage even if it's blocked, so the same deal. And it's probably more plus on block too, so this is really good for opening people up. This is better than like any kind of like drive rush situation, because he grabs you and then puts you into his mix. You know what I mean? Like for 2 bars, he can like do that instead of like rolling up on you, make sure the Oki's right and whatever. Like he just gets to take a mix when you block that. That's crazy. Yep, there it is. That looks weird, actually. Yeah, it's a little strange. It kind of just pulls straight in. The only downside is that you can't go into the charge stance or feint with this version. Ah, okay. So once you do it, you gotta do it. Okay. That's fair enough. Kill Rush. A technique that allows you to go quickly move forward. 2 different types of attacks are possible during the technique, which are timing dependent. Okay. Perform a bob and weave while taking a step back, useful for helping to create distance from the opponent while analyzing the situation. Kill Rush forward is effective when you need to close the gap. The backward version is good for creating space, all the while not leaving you open to attack. It avoids attacks? Is that what you're telling me? During Kill Rush forward, you got 2 attack options, both the same input, but different timings. Get the input in during the first half of the rush for Kill Switch break, or do it in the latter half to bust out Kill Switch Chaser. So that's break, and this is Chaser. Okay, what's the difference here? Either attack will leave you open to counter, so keep this one in the pocket until you can use it to end a combo. Okay. Okay, so... yeah, see, that he did the chaser into the breaker. This is the timing, but it's the same input. It's really interesting. Costume?
Psycho Storm.
Unleash a series of high-speed flicker jabs, cloaking psycho power, useful as a combo winder or as a counterattack by using its invincibility time. Naturally, typical level one. Hey, good conversion into that too. And it reaches a long way ways too, holy shit. Great reach, nice combo ability. On top of that, this attack is invincible to everything except projectiles, natural. Don't be shy about being a jerk with it. Keep your finger on the trigger and blast it when you have a chance. Just be sure that when you go for it, you know it's going to hit. Miss with this and you're going to be, I mean, yeah. Right at big time, naturally. Level fucking one. Psycho Cadence is a V-Trigger 1 from Street Fighter 5. Generates a ball of Psycho Power, then sends it flying straight ahead with a punch. This multi-hitting attack can be useful in combos. Yeah, this was the same deal with his V-Trigger 1 in Street Fighter 5. Ooh! See, okay, that's the thing about Psycho Cannon from Street Fighter 5, is that it didn't end with something so comboable like that. But let's check that again, right? Yeah, I didn't even charge it. Wow. Really crazy, actually. This cannon's got some juice, and it goes on for a while. If it connects, you got yourself an open invitation to a combo to your liking, and if the opponent blocks it, you're still at an advantage, naturally. Oh, wow, you can just let that fucker rip, then go for a mix. What's more, the speed of the projectile changes depending on the button pressed. From afar, using the light version, release a slow-moving projectile and follow it is a game plan that I like to lean on. Yeah, this is something you did in 5. That's really fucking fast, actually. Yeah, follow behind it. Uppercut. And Psycho Chamber, baby! Ties together the feet and hands of an opponent for delivering a series of powerful shots all over their body, a versatile move that can counter projectiles, be used in combos, and can turn the tables when under pressure. So level 3 shenanigans. Ah, so what we saw was his normal one. This is the most dangerous weapon in your arsenal. It comes complete with high attack power and invincibility, but leaves you defenseless if it doesn't hit. Use it in combos or to punish an opponent when they're wide open, naturally. Naturally. Oh, critical air version. Naturally, that's sick nasty. Let's catch it again. Hey, that's sick nasty. That is sick nasty. Yeah, it's a little bit weaker on the front end for sure. Yeah, I think they could draw that out a little bit longer to have some more impact. But definitely cool though. Definitely super sick. Yeah, man, super excited to play. I'm super, super excited.
Sigma Alpha 2 heading due south over the city. We're en route.
All right, gang. Well, pretty productive little stream. I'm gonna try to stream more, naturally, over time, so. We're going for that 1500. You know? Good old buddy Gotcha got it. It's my turn next, so hope you guys can help me get there. More remixes, more streams. Gonna be starting up my radio DJ thing I've been doing. See if that works out more. And yeah, it's gonna be an exciting year, man. You guys get ready. All right, we'll see you guys on the flip. You guys take it easy. Peace.